That Olympic dream just started since I was a kid. Coach Bobby Weaver was actually Lehigh's last and only Olympic champion.
The roar is for Bobby Weaver.
Watching his Olympic final match and seeing how excited and how proud he was, the way the commentators were talking about him.
Gold medalist, Bobby Weaver, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
Seeing that kind of stuff at a young age inspired me, you know, to one day do the same thing.
Darian Cruz, Lehigh's first champion since 2011.
And now we're going to Paris.
Tell me what it was like growing up here in Allentown.
Growing up around here, a lot of little kids to play with. We rode a lot of bikes, you know, skateboard, that kind of stuff. Got into trouble, rolled around in the dirt. There's a park right down the road here. Always doing sports, though, always getting out of the house.
We knew very early on that he had a natural talent athletically.
Hold up, Jerry, hold up!
I started wrestling when I was around 3 or 4, and my family poured into me. And you know, my parents have been my biggest supporters. My grandparents have been my biggest supporters.
Sometimes he was a self-starter. Other times, I like to think that I helped him see what potential he had.
Darian Cruz in the Hug It Out with his dad, Randy.
I would encourage him and his brothers to push towards that end.
Inside track, bang, right there. Understand?
Group effort.
They've done so much. They've sacrificed so much. Not only traveling near and far for competition, training, that kind of stuff. They sought out to learn more wrestling as well.
As soon as that hand's going, you're reacting.
So they took us to guys like Bobby Weaver, right? This area is really big in wrestling, but we were always seeking that knowledge. How are you doing?
When did you see this kind of rise in him?
I knew about him when he was about 8th grade. You know, you just know names. You don't know how they're gonna do in high school, just like you don't know how high school kids are gonna do in college, but then I followed his high school career. He got hurt, unfortunately, his freshman year, but then he just kind of rolled after that, and he was just a lot of fun to watch. He has a great mind for the sport, and I think that's a big part of it. You love what you're doing, you have a great mind for it, and you work really hard, you can have great results. He's one of the best athletes ever coached, one of the best wrestlers ever coached, so I'm really excited for him.
So, Darian, I know that you won a gold medal, but before we get to Paris, you got to stop in this bakery. It's the best bakery in Bethlehem. You're pretty much gonna want everything in the case.
Let's do it.
After you.
You're wrestling for Puerto Rico. Nancy has a Puerto Rican bakery here.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me connection here.
Yeah, so this feels just like at home. You know what I mean? I grew up with an abuela, you know, very similar in stature and culturally, so.
Or are you going to promise that when you win a medal at the Olympics, you're coming back again?
Yeah, you know, when I win gold, I'm gonna come back, Nancy, and hopefully we can make a donut together. I mean, my culture, my family, we grew up in a lot of pride. You know, bearing the Puerto Rico flag is something that the island takes a lot of pride in. Talking to my family about it, you know, I was a little distraught, right? You grow up thinking you're gonna represent the United States, you know, being born here. And we decided to make that decision as a family. And, you know, it's one of the greatest decisions I made in my life. Going to the island and seeing, you know, kids of your color, hair color, stature, structure, culture, makes me even more grateful that I can be somebody of influence in that manner. You know, just the idea of being that role model to be able to chase a dream and inspire the next generation, so.
So I'm going to fast forward for you to the first week of August. The 125-pound bracket's over. You're the last man standing, literally. The referee lifts your arm. People are cheering. Lights are flashing. You step to the podium. You lean down. They put the medal around your neck. You hear the Puerto Rican anthem. Can you imagine what you're going to be feeling like at that moment?
Even talking about it, I start to get chills and you know, sweat a little bit. Just even as a young kid, thinking about standing on top of that podium, thinking about the amount of joy and pride I will bring my family, you know, my team, people around that supported me, and myself, I think is going to speak volumes. I'm more than ready to accomplish this goal and this dream, and you know, I'm excited to get prepared every single day.